Wang Yidi will begin here with the serve.
One, love.
Seen so many Chinese players using that hurricane long blade now. The Ma long blade. But you'll see the Chinese players have their own face actually stamped underneath it.
Love.
Bit of customization, never does any harm. It was a good adjustment from Hanagoda, but Wang Yidi always on top. And she's a player that loves to wear a heart on her sleeve, Hanagoda. Positive, that's fine, but you don't want to give the Chinese any more confidence. Showing your frustration. Wow, it's just that relentless attacking prowess. Into the middle, wide backhand. It's just constantly changing, and yet the power is always there.
Five, love.
These little differences that make a huge difference, and player outside of the Chinese national team barely gets any chance to play them. And all of a sudden you're here in the Infinity Arena against one of the top four.
One, five. Two, five.
Shows a lot of confidence going for the long, fast serve so often here. Perhaps she feels like she's got a better chance in the rally than trying to counter or open up against Wang Yidi.
Three,
one of the biggest differences you'll see between juniors and the top world players and seniors is that you barely ever see them blocking on the forehand. It'll always be a counter, usually. Blocking on the backhand, more common. Wow.
Four, six.
Managing to make space from the middle there is very impressive. Perfect angle to see it. A strawberry flick as well to begin. And then a seatbelt. Quite a high one. Probably safer having it a bit lower.
Four, seven.
But Wang Yidi is obviously pinning that forehand side a bit more regularly. Mm. That was a nice combination there.
Five.
Ooh.
Eight. Five.
And Goda managed to make a bit of momentum for herself there, but that net just completely neutralised it. Wang Yidi 8-5 to the good. Mm. I'm impressed with the strawberries. That one had a bit more backspin on it and was quite deep. Deep as can be, actually, without it being an edge. But Wang Yidi able to adapt. Something the Chinese have had to really be wary of, especially against the Japanese.
6-9.
But this has been, I'd say, a good game here from Hanagoda. Wow. You've got to love that combination there. This young Egyptian here. That's three or four long, fast serves, and she keeps the bat high and just sails away with it. This is such an interesting match. Ooh. Well, that serve. Either look too heavy to strawberry or a miscontact on the strawberry, but regardless of that, 10-7 to Wang Yidi.
Eight, 10.
Well, we've seen more strawberries this game than we've seen in Wimbledon. And she's been effective with it. It's something a little bit different. Players that are able to do something different with a bit of feeling, they're the ones that can usually beat the Chinese. When they do beat them, that is. But 11-8, I think Hanagoda will take that.
Game two,
and she nods as though to say, yeah. Ooh, catches the edge, but to be fair, she made Wang Yidi misread the serve and got the third ball attacking opportunity. This is the best I've seen Hanagoda on the big stage in terms of a champions or a star contender I can remember.
Love, two.
When she lost to Bernie Such at the Summer Series, she didn't play her best, but she's playing very, very well here. Can't imagine her playing much better against a top four Chinese player right now anyway.
Love, three.
And a nice Chiquita flick as well. She's showing her feeling here. On the ball.
Three,
that's a good serve.
One.
Seeing professional players do a lot of long serves with backspin now. We know the left-handers like to go for the bottle challenge serve, which is down the line into a right-hander's backhand. But Hannah Goda and Wang Yidi here have been illustrating some good topspin and backspin long serves.
Four,
and she's
one.
Really on it right now. Majed Ashour in the corner. But you sometimes fear for anyone up on the Chinese that the Chinese are going to raise their gear. What a counter! Painting the table, she brushes through with the backhand. 6-1 up. Recovers the net cord. Wow, Wang Yidi did remarkably well there to recover that one into the middle. As well as get the strawberry back and then get back that punch and the one from the middle. I mean, come on. I mean, you can't really do much more there if you're Hannah Goda, to be honest. Brilliant game to watch this is.
6-3.
These are the rallies that you think of really at the top level of the women's game, the backhand to backhand, off the bounce, switches down the line, then you might see a loop to loop. And Wang Yidi is going to win those in terms of most of the time.
5-6.
And this is a massive run of momentum
six.
Here. Akram Benatia just for reminding the youngster not to touch the table. That's the umpire's job if there's a bit of sweat on there. Well,
seven,
she got a little net
five.
There which stops the momentum of Wang Yidi, but still she had a bit to do there with the forehand and she did well. Because of the flair Hannah Goda has, even Wang Yidi there wasn't sure whether she was going to fade it cross court or play down the line, and that was what made Wang Yidi indecisive on the forehand block.
7-6.
But even regardless of this match, just seeing a young Egyptian here under the age of 18 challenging a top four Chinese like this makes you wonder whether we're going to see the continental representation in the Olympics in women's like we have in the men's. Oh, she escapes there. I thought Wang Yidi had that dead and buried. As soon as it goes to that distance, loop to loop, you think it's Wang Yidi's point, but she missed contact at the forehand. Took it a little bit too late. 6-8. Wang Yidi with the serves.
7-8.
You see a lot of communication between Hannah Goda and her coach in the corner. Reassuring. I'm just looking over to see what the reminder of the tactics is about.
8. Didn't survive
that time though. Wang Yidi, as soon as she's on the front foot, is so good. Hannah Goda gesturing over to her coach to say, what more could I do there?
P. Please play 8-8.
Lachlan Bonnetier not wanting any time wasting. 8-all.
Let 8-8.
Wow. Defining backhand slowed things down, and Wang Yidi then got a little bit nervous on the backhand side. Hannah Goddo with a chance. She needs to take this game, you feel, if she is to have any chance of progressing through. She doesn't take this game. Wouldn't surprise me to see Wang Yidi win 3-0. What nine. A rally. Nine. The ball seems to be on a string, and Wang Yidi. Ooh, it sat up enough.
Nine.
So much different variation on the ball coming in from both sides. What a brush up from Wang Yidi off the half long. And Wang Yidi escapes. I didn't think I'd be saying that. But indeed, Hannah Goddo does better in the second game than what she does in the first. She could be a top 20 world player in a short amount of time.
One, love.
67% year-to-date win-loss ratio, Hannah Goddo. Wang Yidi, 82. It comes down. Does that one? Ooh, misses by
love
a whisker.
Two.
Fans probably wanted that to go on. Just tried
love
to punch down
three
the line flat, but the ball had dropped a little
time
bit
out
too low. Timeout comes now. Now, wow.
3-1.
A strawberry against a float ball. You can't doubt the talent of the young Egyptian. Very good hand skill. She's putting all the shots together and the shot selection that comes with a little bit more experience.
4-1.
But her body language has actually been very good.
Two, four.
Bit of fortune there. Look at the receive. Brilliant. And Wang Yidi just tried to bait her in the wide forehand. Should I say wide backhand to then perhaps try and block it to the open court. But it was a decent put away there from the 14-year-old.
3-4.
She's not a player, Wang Yidi, that you will see smiling when she plays at all. She's so stern-faced.
Hannah
Goddo and Akram Benatia are very close friends. So it shows you the professionality of
four,
Akram Benatia
four
that he put to that side when he's umpiring. Wow, scintillating. Apart from forgiving.
Four, six.
Wow.
Five.
I know she's had
six
a few lucky net, but the way that she's adapting to the big stage here, Hannah Goddo, is something that I haven't seen her do yet. She is slowly growing into this stage, this level of pressure with all the lights.
So sorry.
Oh my goodness, I mean,
six
that was a so sorry.
Six.
Oh, and I wonder how much of the frustration came out in a long, fast serve. Wang Yidi's going to have to keep a cool here. Hannah Gutter fighting. What a turnaround. That's a nice counter there.
7-7.
She's just so compact. She's built very low to the table, stocky, strong base, moves well. Doesn't pivot as much as Sun Ying Shao or Wang Man Yu though, Wang Yidi.
7-8.
Two points in a row for Wang Yidi now. Oh well, nine. That time it wasn't going to come over the net. She was caught indecisively there because of the half-long touch of Wang Yidi. When it's half-long, I guess you could define it as a push or a touch, but looked like it was going to be short.
9-8.
Something about these cyber-shaped players, they love a punch.
Stop, Wang, be fast, please. 9-8.
Ooh, it sat up, but Wang Yidi couldn't put it away. Nine. She has serves here. I cannot believe how close this has been. It's brilliant. Oh, that's cheeky from Wang Yidi. Bit of swagger, and she walks off into the distance. Like a hero at the end of a movie when the building explodes with the villain inside and doesn't look back. But she has a match point. Oh, the feeling, but can't put the icing on the cake. But I tell you what, a good handshake between...